You guys excited about what Jesus is doing in your life? Amen. So we're going to worship God. I love to worship God. Who loves to worship Jesus? Yes. So that's what we're going to do for a few minutes, and then we'll get into a quick word. I want you guys to get uncomfortable tonight. Just worship. Don't worry about what you
stop your love.
Don't worry about anybody or anything. Just go ahead and just worship Jesus right now. Amen. Give him glory. Thanksgiving for what he's doing in your life. Amen. He's at work in your life in a glorious way. Isn't he? Yes. He's moving mountains in your life. He's moving on your behalf. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus, for what you're going to do tonight, Lord. We glorify Jesus Christ tonight in this place. Jesus, we say you are awesome and mighty in this place. Thank you, Jesus. Be glorified in this place, Lord. Thank you, Lord, that you're here. Thank you for the people of God in this place. Speak to us tonight, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for Psalm chapter 107:20. He sent his word and healed them and delivered them from their destruction. Thank you, Lord, for standing your word. Thank you, Lord. Who is like you, O God? You who have shown us great and severe troubles shall quicken us again and bring us up from the depths of the earth. You shall increase our greatness and comfort us on every side. Thank you, Jesus. Bless you. Father, we ask you tonight in the name of thy servant Jesus Christ to bless the body of Christ tonight, that they would be healed and changed, God. Lord, they came here for a blessing, oh God. They came here to get healed, oh God. They came here to get delivered. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We declared Colossians chapter 1, verse 13, who had delivered us from the power of darkness and had translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the promise of Hebrews chapter 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Amen. Do you believe that? Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for the blood from the cross, Father. Hallelujah. Thank you for the shed blood from the cross of Jesus Christ. Revelation chapter 12, verse 11. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Hallelujah. Come on, you're overcoming by the blood of the Lamb. Amen. It's happening. You're in that process of overcoming every devil that's coming against you. You're in that process of overcoming every demonic circumstance that is coming against you. You're in that process tonight. You were in that process yesterday. You'll be in that same process tomorrow of being an overcomer.
No sin, no shame, no past, no pain.
Yet in all these things, we more than conquer. Are you more than a conqueror? Yes, you are. You're not just a conqueror, huh? You're not just a conqueror. I mean, that'd be great if you were just a conqueror, wouldn't it? Hallelujah, but you're more than a conqueror. How? through him that loves us, through him that loved us. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Come on, I want you to lift up the name of Jesus with me tonight. Just shout his name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for what you're going to do tonight. Have your way in this place. Thank you, Jesus. We speak the name of Jesus Christ. Him hath God highly exalted and given him a name which is above every name. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. These signs shall follow them that believe in my name, shall they cast out devils. Thank you, Jesus, for that weapon. Thank you for the name of Jesus. Father, you've entrusted us with the name of thy servant, Jesus. You've given us the name of Jesus. So tonight we use it as a weapon. Tonight we declare the name of Jesus against all principality and powers. Tonight we declare the name of Jesus over hell. We shout. Come on, give. We shout unto God. We shout, hallelujah, the name of Jesus. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah. Come on, lift up holy hands and give them a holy shout and say, Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, have your way. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the people of God in this place. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Romans chapter 8, verse 11. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal body by his spirit that dwelleth in you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank quicken our bodies tonight. Quicken our mind. Quicken our soul, Holy Ghost. Quicken our lives, our soul, our mind. Quicken our bodies. Oh, Shakalaba. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Repeat this after me. Say, Lord, I'm ready. Speak to your people tonight, and I'll never be the same. In Jesus' name. So tonight I want to talk about a sermon called When You Follow Jesus. When you follow Jesus. In Matthew chapter 4, verse 19, Jesus said, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Praise God, because when you follow Jesus, he's going to make you, right? He's going to make you. Jesus is in the process of making you who you're really supposed to be. Matthew chapter 9, verse 9, Jesus said, the Bible says, and Jesus passed on from there. He saw a man named Matthew sitting at the tax office, and he said to him, follow me. Say that with me, follow me. Jesus said, follow me. So he arose and followed him. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Father, I thank you for the beautiful church in the house of God. Father, I pray that you would edify and strengthen them and encourage them tonight and bless them. Have your way in your glorious name, Jesus. Everybody said amen. So that Greek word there for follow is akolutheho, which simply means to follow one who leads, to join him as his attendant, to accompany him, to join as a disciple, to become his disciple. I love that, because when you follow Jesus, you're a disciple of the Lord Jesus. Amen. We're followers of, we're disciples of the Lord Jesus. And tonight I want to just shed some light on what happens when we sincerely follow Jesus Christ. Amen. Because there's a difference. Hallelujah. There's a difference from getting from saying a prayer, right? You say a prayer and then nothing changes. And then you get mad at God and you blame him for everything. And then you backslide. But you'll get into heaven though, because you said that prayer and you're pursuing Christianity, but there's a difference, right? There's a carnal Christian, there's a lazy Christian, and then there's a disciple and a follower of Jesus Christ. And I'm going to encourage you guys tonight, because last time I was here, people were looking a little discouraged. So I'm going to focus on making sure you guys are edified, amen? So some Christians follow self. They follow social media. They follow the world. They follow man. They follow feelings and emotions. They follow fame and titles. They follow Satan. They follow comfort and compromise. But when you follow Jesus, you're never going to be the same. Amen. I'm here to tell you tonight that when you follow Jesus Christ, your life is never going to be the same. You will never be the same when you pursue Jesus with all your heart. When you surrender to Jesus, when you're abandoned to the living God, when you say, Jesus, you're alive, Jesus, you're real, Jesus, you are Lord, Jesus, you are King, Jesus, you are Deliverer, I'm yours, I'll follow you all the days of my life. Hallelujah. That is us, amen? Jesus said in John chapter 8, verse 12, I am the light of the world. He that follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Is that good? I love that. When you follow Jesus, you hear his voice in a glorious way. His divine voice is a reality to you. Is that true? You're going to hear the voice of Jesus in a greater way when you simply surrender and when you say, I'm going to follow Jesus. I don't care what my family's doing. I don't care what my sister's doing. I don't care what my coworkers are doing. I don't even care what my children are doing. Oh, I'm going to pray for them, but if they're going to choose the devil, then I'll pray for them. But I'm going to follow Jesus with all my heart. Amen. We're going to follow Jesus, and you're going to hear his voice in a mighty way. That voice is leading you and guiding you into truth. You know that you're not alone anymore. You have confidence and new courage now. Do you believe that? You don't make choices based on feelings and emotions. That small, still voice of the Spirit brings peace and joy with every major decision in your life. Jesus said in John 10:27, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. Hallelujah. Praise God. Let's look at the life of the Apostle Paul in Acts chapter 22, verse 14 and 15. This is where Ananias prays for him and he receives his sight. But Ananias says, the God of our fathers hath chosen thee that thou shouldest know his will. How many of us know that when you follow Jesus Christ, you're going to know his will for your life? Then he goes on to say, and see that just one. Can I just tell you that when you follow Jesus, you're going to see Jesus. When you follow Jesus with all your heart, when you give Jesus 100%, you're going to see Jesus in a different way. You're going to see Jesus in a greater way. Then he goes on to say that thou should hear the voice of his mouth, for thou shalt be his witness unto all men of what thou hast seen and heard. In Joel chapter 2, verse 11, the Bible says, Jehovah hath given forth his voice before his force. Hallelujah. His voice is going before you. Amen. For very great is his camp, for mighty is the doer of his word. I like that. We need to be a beautiful people of God that is so persistent and determined in following Jesus Christ like Elisha was when he followed the prophet Elijah. Amen. Elisha was an Old Testament prophet and a disciple of Elijah. Elijah never saw death because he was taken up to heaven by a chariot of fire. Remember that story? Elisha knew that, but he wanted a double portion of his spirit before he was taken up. Right? Okay, let's check that out. Let's read about that. In 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 1 through 14, the Bible says, it came to pass when the Lord was about to take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. Then Elijah said to Elisha, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me on to Bethel. But Elisha said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you. So they went down to Bethel. Now the sons of the prophets who were at Bethel came out to Elisha and said to him, do you know that the Lord will take away your master from you today? And he said, yes, I know. Keep silent. Hallelujah. He's pretty determined, isn't he? I like Elisha. I really do. In verse 4, if you're following along, once again, it's in 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 1 through 14. So verse 4 says, then Elijah said to him, Elisha, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me on to Jericho. So I don't know what was going on with Elijah, but it seems like he was hating on Elisha. Right? He's just trying to get rid of him in every way that he can. And so he says, I'm going on to Jericho. But Elisha responds, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you. Verse 5, now the sons of the prophets who were at Jericho came to Elisha and said to him, do you know that the Lord will take away your master from you today? So he answered, yes, I know. Keep silent. That's good. Then Elijah said to him, stay here, please, for the Lord has sent me onto the Jordan. But he said, as the Lord lives and as your soul lives, I will not leave you. I like his attitude, don't you? So like Elisha, we need to do the same thing, amen? We're going to say, as the Lord lives, I will follow Jesus Christ all the days of my life. As the Lord lives, I will not turn back. As the Lord lives, I will not believe the lies of the devil. As the Lord lives, I will not live a defeated life. As the Lord lives, I will not be denied the promises of God. As the Lord lives, I am the new creation. As the Lord lives, I can do all things through the Christ who strengthens me. As the Lord lives, I am more than a conqueror. As the Lord lives, I am an overcomer. As the Lord lives, I am overcoming. As the Lord lives, I overcame. Come on, say that with me. Say, I overcome. I am overcoming. I overcame. Why are you going to overcome? Because Jesus said you would. Amen. In 1 John chapter 5, verse 5, the Bible says, who is he that overcomes the world but he that believes that Jesus is the Son of God? Do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God?
Yes.
Then you're an overcomer, amen? So Elijah kept trying to get rid of Elisha. But Elisha remembered the call of God. There was nowhere else for him to go. He was not going to compromise his ministry. He was not going to miss his divine appointment. He was not moved by circumstances. He made a choice and he never looked back. How much greater is our call? He was following Elijah, but we follow the Son of God. Do you believe that? We need to be the most determined and persistent followers of Jesus Christ that the world has ever known. In 2 Kings chapter 2, verses 11 and through 13, we see Elisha's breakthrough. It says, and it came to pass, and as they still went on and talked, that behold, there appeared a chariot of fire and horses of fire, which parted them both asunder. And Elijah went up by a whirlwind into heaven, and Elisha saw it and cried out, my father, to the chariots of Israel and the horsemen thereof. And he saw him no more. And he took up his, his own clothes, and rent them in two pieces. He took up also the mantle of Elijah. I like that because he was persistent, he was determined, and he was not going to be denied, and he got the mantle of Elijah. When you follow Jesus Christ, you might catch a mantle. Hallelujah. So when you follow Jesus, you decrease and he increases. I like that. When you follow Jesus, you decrease and he increases. Look what Jesus said in Luke chapter 9, verse 23. If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross daily and follow me. But Satan wants you self-centered. Satan wants you self-absorbed and self-focused and self-righteous and proud and selfish and big-headed. But God wants you selfless and submissive and humble. Hallelujah. That's a good word, isn't it? Say that with me tonight. Say humble. God wants you selfless, submissive, and humble as a genuine follower of Jesus Christ. In 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 5 through 7, Peter says, likewise, you younger people, submit yourselves to your elders. Yes, all of you be submissive to one another. And you like the sound of that? Be submissive to one another. Do you do that in the local church? Do you do that with the body of Christ? Sometimes. That's not a good answer. Hallelujah. Thanks for your honesty. But he says, all of you be submissive to one another and be clothed with humility. I love that because then he goes on to tell you why. Because God resists the proud but gives grace to the humble. I don't know about you, but I don't want God to resist me in any way. Therefore, I don't want to have anything to do with the demon of pride. Hallelujah. You got to do whatever you got to do to overcome that devil of pride, because all he wants to do is steal, kill, and destroy. So he goes on to say, but God gives grace to the humble. Isn't that beautiful? I want the grace of God in my life. I want to remain humble in all areas of my life. And I need the grace of God in all areas of my life. Therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting all your care upon him, for he careth for you. Hallelujah. You're going to give all your cares to Jesus Christ. All your worry, all the care, all the anxiety, every issue, every concern, you're determined to follow Jesus Christ, and you're going to give him all your cares. And he's going to do a great work in your life. But if you want, hallelujah, give him a hand clap. But if you want to hang on to everything, and if you want to be in control, and if you want to figure everything out, then you're going to be in trouble. That's pride. Pride wants to be in control, and pride wants to trust self, and pride wants to control everybody else. That's witchcraft. You release it to God. You cast all your cares on God, and you're not going to worry, and you're not going to be afraid because you're following the risen Christ. Amen. And you know that he's leading you. Hallelujah. You know he's leading you. This isn't some boring, dead religion. Hallelujah. We have the resurrected Christ at the right hand of the Father. This is not Buddhism. Amen. This is not Hinduism. We have a real life, exciting, intimate relationship with the King of Kings. And you're submitted to him and you're following him and your life will never be the same. Amen? I believe that with all my heart. Look at what Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2 says. I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your body as a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewal of your mind. So I like where he says that you're a living sacrifice. That's good, isn't it? You lay your life, you lay your body on the altar of God, amen? And you're still alive, but it's Christ that's living in you. Like Paul said in Galatians 2:20, I am crucified with Christ. Nevertheless, I live, yet not I, but Christ liveth in me. Remember that scripture? When you follow Jesus, the storms of life actually benefit you. When you follow Jesus, the storms of life will actually benefit you and increase you rather than destroy you. You grow because of the storm. Come on, hallelujah. You're going to grow. You're not going to be the same. You're becoming a new creation. You're becoming a new man and a new woman because you're a follower of Jesus Christ in the storm. Hallelujah. You're going to the next level because of the storm. I say praise God for the storm. And I say I'm thankful for the storm because I know Jesus is going to reveal himself in a greater way. It gives Jesus an opportunity to show up, to show you how powerful he really is. Right? What about the disciples when Jesus told them to go across that sea, remember? And the storm came against them and Jesus was sleeping. He was crashed out, wasn't he? He was tired. He was out. He was asleep. And the storm came and Peter, they were all afraid. And they thought they were going to die. But thank God for that storm. Hallelujah. Because Jesus woke up and he spoke to that storm. And he told that storm to be still. And they got a greater, because of that storm, they saw Jesus at work. And they got a greater revelation of who Jesus is. And that's the same thing that's going on in your life through that storm. You gain a greater revelation of the Christ in all of his glory because you see him in action in the storm. Your anointing will increase. And the grace of God gives ability you didn't have prior to the storm. Because you maintained your following of the Christ in that storm, whatever that circumstance was, whatever that symptom is, whatever those demons are trying to do, however they're trying to come against you, you're following the Christ, you're pursuing God, you're submitted to God, you're submitted to his word, and you're going to grow in the storm. Look at Matthew chapter 7, verse 24 and 25. Jesus said, therefore, whoever hears these sayings of mine and does them, I will liken him to a wise man who built his house on the rock. And the rain descended and the floods came and the winds blew and beat on that house. And what happened? It did not fall because it was founded on the rock. I say hallelujah. That is us. That is the body of the Christ. We hear the word of God and we're going to be doers of the word of God. And in that storm, our house is not going to move. Peter in the storm. Remember when Peter walked on water? Right? Everyone loves to discredit Peter, don't they? They're always being negative when it comes to Peter. They focus on what he did wrong. But I say, I'm here to tell you tonight that Peter was the only natural person to ever walk on water. Is that true? Peter was never the same because of the storm. Peter was never the same because of the storm. Is that true? When you follow the divine master, you will suffer. It got quiet in here. When you follow the master, you will suffer. You'll be laughed at, discredited, and hated on. People will think you're crazy. People will say you're part of a cult. Or you're going down to that Arizona Deliverance Center, man. They're a cult over there, man. You better watch out, brother. They do some strange things over there. They do some crazy things over there. Well, I know that before I met Jesus, I did some crazy things for the devil. So now I want to be radical and do some crazy things for the glory of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm going to follow Jesus. I don't care how crazy it looks. I don't care what anybody has to say. I follow Jesus all the days of my life. Not because of what he's done for me, because of who he is. He's the Son of the living God. And he died for your sin. And by his stripes, you are healed. You'll be laughed at, discredited. No matter what the evil circumstance comes against you, regardless of how you feel, the discomforts of life, the challenges and the trials, it won't be easy. Say it tonight, it won't be easy. We can just be honest tonight, right? It won't be easy. That's okay. But you know who you're following. You know who you're following, don't you? You know you follow Jesus Christ. You know how glorious he is. You know what he's done for you. You know how mighty he is. You know there's more power in one drop of the blood, of the shed blood of the risen Christ, than all of hell. You know that's true, isn't it? We have a vindicator. Hallelujah. Jesus is going to vindicate your life. Jesus is going to vindicate your ministry. Jesus is going to vindicate your family. Jesus is going to vindicate your finances. Jesus is going to vindicate your body. Hallelujah. We're going to follow Christ even when someone does us dirty. 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 20 and 21. Peter said, "For what credit is there if when you sin and are harshly treated, you endure it with patience? But if when you do what is right and suffer for it, if you patiently endure it, this finds favor with God." I love that. "For you have been called for this purpose, since Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example for you to follow his footsteps." Glory to God. You might not want to hear this tonight, but I'm here to tell you, you might have to suffer a little bit, but it's okay. You're following Jesus Christ. All things work together for good to them that love God, to them called according to purpose. Romans chapter 8, verse 28. So when you follow Jesus, he'll give you more reasons to follow him. Demon powers will be destroyed. Curses will be broken. Miracles, signs, and wonders will break out in your life and your ministry. The mighty gifts of the Holy Ghost will begin to operate in your life. Unbelief and doubt disappear. You walk by faith. You're a doer of the word now. In Hebrews chapter 12, verse 2, Paul said, "Looking unto Jesus, the author and finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and is set down at the right hand of the throne of God." So we're looking unto Jesus, and he's the author and the finisher of our faith. Are you looking under the natural realm? Are you looking at your natural circumstance? No. You are Jesus' priority and his responsibility. And he is obligated to guide your every step when you follow him. In 2015, one of the most difficult times of my life, my wife wanted to get a divorce. And I left our home. And then, I was separated from my children. So it was really a difficult situation in my life. Very tough. In business, I had 2 years. I had just embarked in a new business opportunity, and I had 2 years to graduate a rookie sales program. If I didn't graduate it, I would be unemployed. But can I just tell you tonight that God will maneuver, and he will plan, and he will strategize signs and wonders for you to encourage you. Hallelujah. I was born again on January 26, 2008. That is the day that I checked into the Phoenix Dream Center and I gave my life to Jesus Christ. A year later, that same day, I get hired where I work at. Same day, January 26th. So one night at 2:30 in the morning, I fell under a trance and I wasn't awake, but I wasn't asleep. And I heard the voice of Jesus coming out of my spirit, man. And I heard a voice. And it said, I'm here, I love you. And he knew that I needed to hear it twice, so he said it again. I'm here, I love you. So this is coming out of, it was strange. It was a little weird. It was coming out of my belly, my spirit, man. I could feel his voice pulsating out of my side. Guess what date that was? January 26, 2015. A year later, I celebrated graduating that rookie program on that same date. Hallelujah. Through the storm, God was with me. And now I can fully understand 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. Hallelujah. Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Do you believe that? 1 John chapter 4, verse 4. When you follow Jesus, Say that with me. You guys are too quiet. Say, when you follow Jesus, when you follow Jesus, he will set you ablaze by the fire of God. In Luke chapter 24, you don't have to repeat that part, but Luke chapter 24, verse 32, I'm sorry. Jesus, the Bible says in Luke 24, 32, did not our heart burn within us while he talked with us by the way and while he opened to us the scriptures? Hallelujah. I want my heart to burn within me by the fire of God. I want to open up those scriptures and I want my heart to burn for the living God, because I'm following the resurrected Christ and I want to burn with passion for his word. I want to burn with passion for his presence. I want to burn with passion for his love in my life, because I know that his fire and his presence and his love is going to change me forevermore. I'll never be the same. Hallelujah. In Luke chapter 12, verse 49, Jesus said, I've come to set the world on fire, and I wish it were already burning. Did you know that? Have you heard that scripture before? If you've never heard that scripture before, then you need to get to that address. Get to that scripture. Luke 12, 49. I have come to set the world on fire, and I wish it were already burning, saith Jesus. I want miracle contact with the fire of God, for miracle impact with the people of God. You will be a firebrand follower, evangelist, and a servant of the living God when he sets you on fire, because you are dedicated to him and his glorious cause. Do you believe that? God is going to set you on fire because you are dedicated to him and his cause. His work is your priority. You will be specialized and authorized and anointed and appointed by tongues of fire. In Acts chapter 2, verses 2 through 3, the Bible says, suddenly there came from heaven a noise like a rush, like a violent rushing wind, and it filled the whole house. There were the whole house where they were sitting. Then there appeared to them divided tongues as of fire, and one sat upon each of them. I like that, because it says that tongues of fire sat on each of them. What that means is that you have a tongue of fire. God has a divided tongue of fire specifically for you and for your ministry. Do you believe that? Yeah. In verse 4, the Bible says, they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit gave them utterance. In Revelation chapter 19, verse 12 through 14, the Bible says, speaking about Jesus, his eyes were as flames of fire. And on his head were many crowns, and he had a name written that no man knew but he himself. And he was clothed with a vesture dipped in blood, and his name is called the Word of God. And the armies which were in heaven followed him upon white horses, clothed in fine linen, white and clean. Come on, give Jesus a hand clap for that. So I believe that if you'll follow Jesus Christ, now you're going to follow him in the next life. Amen. In Luke 3:16, the Bible says, John answered, saying to all, I indeed baptize you with water, but one more mightier than I, whose sandals I'm not worthy to unloose, he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. And we're going to do that tonight. Amen. We're going to pray for the fire of God to be poured out. When you follow the divine master, you'll obtain miracles, the children's bread, and divine healing. Psalm 34:4, King David said, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. Psalm 63:8 says, my soul followeth hard after thee, thy right hand upholdeth me. In Matthew chapter 15, verses 22 through 28, we have the story of the Canaanite woman whose daughter was grievously vexed with the devil. I'll read that quickly. It says, and behold, a woman of Canaan came from that region and cried out to him, saying, have mercy on me, O Lord, son of David. My daughter is severely demon-possessed. But he answered her not a word, and his disciples came and urged him, saying, send her away, for she cries after us. But he answered and said, I was not sent except to that lost sheep of the house of Israel. Then she came and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, it is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to little dogs. Wow. And she said, yes, Lord, even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table. Hallelujah. Then Jesus answered and said to her, O woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire. And her daughter was healed from that very hour. Praise God that when you're following Jesus Christ, you're not going to be concerned about anything but following him. And you're going to have great faith like this Canaanite woman did. You're going to have a greater faith because you're following Jesus. When you follow Jesus, he provides all your needs. I'm not a prosperity preacher, but I'm not a poverty preacher. Amen. God wants to bless you financially. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19, but my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Do you believe that? Matthew 6, 33, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. God wants to bless you financially. Do you receive that? Do you believe that? Look at Deuteronomy 8, 18. But you shall remember the Lord your God, for it is he who gives you power to make wealth. So just accept that and believe that and act on that, because you need to provide for your children. You need to provide for your family. And God wants to bless you financially so you can expand the kingdom of God financially. Is that true? I know if you give to this ministry, God's going to bless you. So when you follow Jesus, you will be marked by his blood. Say that with me tonight. Say, marked by his blood. Moses in the Old Testament was preparing a burnt offering with Aaron. Turn to Leviticus chapter 8, verses 22 through 20 and 23. Let's break this down. I definitely want to focus on this one, on this point. Leviticus 8, 22 and 23. The Bible says, then he presented the other ram, the ram of ordination, and Aaron and his sons laid their hands on the head of the ram, and he slew it. And Moses took of the blood of it and put it upon the tip of Aaron's right ear and upon the thumb of his right hand and upon the great toe of his right foot. What were they doing there? Why did Moses do that? Let's find out. I have to believe that the blood of the ram has a connection and points to the New Testament blood of the Lamb. The Old Testament was a foreshadowing of the New Testament. What happened in the Old Testament symbolically happens in the New Testament in reality. And just like Moses marked Aaron by the blood of the ram, the Holy Ghost has marked you with the blood of the Lamb for divine protection. Amen. Can I just tell you tonight that the Holy Ghost will mark you by the blood of the Lamb for perfect protection against hell? I believe that with all my heart. We need God's protection, don't we? We need to be marked by the blood of the Lamb, and we need God's perfect protection in life. Not only has every curse been broken by the blood, you are now uncursable. Come on, let me say that again. Not only has every curse been broken by the blood, now if you're going to continue to follow Jesus Christ, if you'll abandon your life to Jesus Christ, if you'll lay your life on the altar of God, if you'll follow Jesus Christ with all your heart, you will be uncursable. Do you believe that with all your heart? Because you follow Christ and he has marked you for service. This is my watch. It's a cheap watch. Okay, but I look after it, right? I protect my watch. I make sure it's put away every evening. You have property, right? Do you protect your property? Hallelujah. God will protect his property. Amen. God is going to protect his property. You are marked by the blood of Jesus Christ. When you follow Jesus, you will know who you are. You are identified with the Christ. Hallelujah. You find your purpose. You know where you're going. You know your purpose. You know where you're going. You have an identity. You know who you are now. Before we met Christ, we didn't know who we were. We didn't know what was going on. I didn't know what I was going to do with my life. I was miserable, tormented. I was headed toward hell. I was bound by demons and rejection and fear and poverty and shame. My life was horrible, terrible, and miserable, bound by the devil. But when I got When I came into this intimate relationship with Jesus Christ, he has shown me who I am. I am his son. Hallelujah. He died for me. He died for you. He loves me. He loves you. He wants the best for you. He's a good Jesus, isn't he? He's a good God. You have inner peace and joy. You're not ashamed of the cross of the Christ. Colossians chapter 2, verses 9 and 10. For in him dwelleth all the fullness of the Godhead bodily, and you are complete in him, which is the head of all principality and power. You're going to be complete in Jesus. Come on. That makes me happy that I can be complete in Jesus Christ. Your life is going to be complete in Jesus Christ. Your ministry will be complete in Jesus Christ. Your health will be complete in Jesus Christ. Your mind will be complete in Jesus Christ. You can have a sound mind, and you can have your sanity, and you can have peace, victory, and inner joy, and you can be more than a conqueror and an overcomer, and you're going to do all things through the resurrected Christ because you're following the Christ. You're not playing games anymore. Look at Psalm chapter 8, verses 4 and 5. This will blow your mind. Psalm chapter 8, verses 4 and 5 is amazing. And I've been meditating on this, and it's a beautiful scripture. And King David said, what is a man that thou art mindful of him? And the son of man that thou visitest him? For thou hast made him but a little lower than God, and crownest him with glory and honor. That is you. Do you believe that? Are you going to identify yourself with the resurrected Christ? Are you going to identify yourself with his word? Are you going to identify with yourself with who he says you are and how he sees you and his opinion of you and his viewpoint of you and your circumstance? Because come on, it can get ugly. These demons are real. Life can get ugly real quick if you want to be in control of everything and handle everything on your own and follow yourself. Right? If you want to follow self, life can get out of control really quick. But when you follow Jesus, he will unveil your specific call on the earth. You're obsessed with the call of God. You prioritize the call. You prepare for the call. You grow for the call. You made a choice to surrender all. You made a choice to surrender to the call of God. He's training you. The Holy Ghost is training you every day for ministry, for your future, to be a man of God, to be a husband, to raise up your daughter in the kingdom way, to be a businessman and a businesswoman and an entrepreneur. God wants to train you to be successful in every area of your life. God does not want you to be free from devils, but live in poverty. God does not want you to be healed, but to have mental illness. God wants to heal your whole body, every area of your life, physically, emotionally, and spiritually. God has a plan for you, and it's beautiful. Do you believe that? I don't know about you, but because Jesus died for my freedom, I want it all. I want all that Jesus died to provide me. I want everything Jesus has to provide. And Jesus has a lot to provide, doesn't he? There's a lot of promises of God. I want every one of them. Hallelujah. He's training you at all times. He's preparing you for service in the kingdom of God. Look at what Jesus said in Luke 9:62. No one having put his hand to the plow and looking back is fit for the kingdom of God. It's time that we take this thing serious, right? I'm taking Jesus serious. We need to take Jesus serious, don't we? He's coming back soon. The world doesn't want to hear it, though, don't they? They don't want to hear it. It's okay. They'll bow one day. When you follow Jesus, His divine presence will be with you. You're not following a denomination. You're not following the world. You're not following past sins. You follow Jesus because He knows, and because He knows you're 100% abandoned to Him, He will be with you. Isaiah 41:10, fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. He's going to uphold you with His righteous right hand because you've submitted to Him. You're following Him. You don't care about any natural circumstance. When you follow Jesus, you want to glorify and magnify Christ. You're not a people pleaser. You're not worried about money, fame, and titles, like some of the church. You're not seeking the praise and honor of man. You don't care how small you start, because you're following the master of the universe. And your only priority in life is to please the divine master of the universe. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I want to please Jesus Christ. I don't care about man. I don't care about the praise of men. I want to please my Lord and Master, my King and my Savior and my Deliverer, Jesus Christ. John 7:18. Let me just get to the scripture. Let me get to the word. John 7:18. He that speaks of himself seeks his own glory. But he that seeks his glory that sent him, the same is true, and no unrighteousness is in him. Jesus said that. When you follow Jesus, he'll remove everything from your life that needs to go. Even if you don't know that it needs to go. Hallelujah. When I first got born again, I didn't even know that. I thought it was okay to drive around without a driver's license. I thought I was cool. I was on the highway and my car shut down and broke down. I thank God for the Holy Ghost that He just said, He snapped His finger, that car is now going to run again. You are not driving until you get your driver's license. And so it broke down and I gave it away. Hallelujah. But because I had to get a driver's license, I hadn't had one in 10 years. And I had to get the breathalyzer. Okay. And my life was out of control. But Jesus brought order. Integrity. But you're going to have to get rid of some things in your life that you do not need. You don't even know they need to go. It might be a little uncomfortable. I was a heroin addict. I was an alcoholic. I was bound by worry and unbelief and fear and shame. And I was proud. Living in poverty. Always compromising. Me and my wife had two miscarriages. And the kids were just born too early that we had to see them. When they were born, they were breathing. They were too small. We had to bury them. But we actually cremated them. I'm sorry. But since I met Jesus, though, Jesus went to work and He gave us three beautiful, healthy, two boys and a girl. Hallelujah. Yeah. Yes, He certainly did. Jesus restored our children back to us. And they're amazing. I thank God that curse of fatherlessness has been broken over my life. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm be there for my children. Praise God. When you follow Jesus, signs follow you. A blind woman. I was walking into a Walmart at 8 in the morning just to buy creamer for my wife. What an amazing husband. Before she was asleep at home. No, but I had to take the kids to school. And then from there, I went to Walmart to buy some creamer. And so as I was walking in the Walmart in some sandals, my hair looked crazy. I don't even think I brushed my grill. However, a woman was walking out and she was being led by her husband and she was blind. And the Holy Ghost said, go pray for her. And I said, Lord, I don't want to pray for her because I know my breath is kicking probably. And I look crazy this morning. It's too early for that. But by, I was led by my spirit, man, and I forced myself. It was uncomfortable, but I did it. And I went up to them and I said, good morning. And I was being very friendly. And then I simply said, what's going on? Are you blind? Can I pray for you? And so we found out that she had spiritual ties to the occult. And so we simply broke that. We had a revival in the parking lot at 8 in the morning. Hallelujah. I commanded her left eye to open. And it didn't open. But then I commanded it again. Hallelujah. And it opened. And she was able to count the fingers I was holding up. Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Manifested himself in a Walmart parking lot at 8 in the morning. And I hadn't brushed my teeth. But it doesn't matter. When the Holy Ghost tells you to do something, you do it. And when you follow Jesus, signs are going to follow you. In Africa, a poor woman, a beautiful woman of God, was carrying a piece of clay that a witch doctor gave her. And the witch doctor said that this clay is going to keep you in health, that you're not going to be sick. However, she was bound by demonic disease because of that clay. And so we took that clay and we stomped on it and we commanded her that disease to leave her, and she was gloriously delivered and healed. Hallelujah. Just two months ago, a man was deaf in his left ear, and we prayed, and his words were, he was surprised. He was happy. He was filled with joy. God opened his ear. He hadn't heard in 14 years. Mark chapter 16, verse 17 and 18. These signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils, speak with new tongues, take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall recover. What I'm telling you, though, is when you follow Jesus Christ, when you make that decision, and when you're going to be determined, and you're going to say, I'm going to follow Jesus, you're going to be persistent. You don't care if all hell comes against you. You don't care what is going on in the natural realm. You have made a choice to follow the resurrected King all the days of your life. And you're going to be a genuine, sincere follower of Jesus Christ, and signs will follow you. Hallelujah. When you follow Jesus, you'll be a worshiper of Jesus. The Bible says, shout unto God with the voice of triumph. When you worship and shout unto God, you're saying, devil, you know what I know. Devil, you know that I know that you are defeated and that you are under my feet. I'll remind you, poor devil, that you are under my feet. This sickness must leave my body now in Jesus' name. You demonic influence and you demonic attack, you demonic mountain, according to Mark 11:23, you must go. You must move. Because devil, you know what I know. And I'm shouting unto God with a voice of triumph. And I worship the resurrected King every day. Every opportunity I get, I want to bring Jesus glory. And I want to worship Jesus. Do you want to worship Jesus? You're shouting your identity to the spirit world. You're meeting the unseen forces of darkness with a mighty confession of who you are. And then Jesus makes it good. Because Jesus is the high priest of your confession. Hebrews chapter 3, verse 1. Therefore, holy brethren, partakers of a heavenly calling, consider the apostle and high priest of our confession. When you follow Jesus, God will help you subdue your enemies in preparation for your ministry. One greater victory after another. Hallelujah. So speaking of King David, let's talk about King David. King David subdued a lion and a bear when he was a shepherd boy. Is that true? Then remember, Samuel anoints him to be king. Then Jesse asked David, his son, to go take food to his brothers that are in a battle, right, against the Philistines. You remember the story. You've probably seen some movie about King David. Because David had subdued a lion and a bear because he was anointed to be king, he didn't see the size of Goliath as a problem. He said, because he's so big, it will be impossible to miss him with my slingshot. And then in 2 Samuel chapter 8, verses 11 through 13, David is subduing nations. Let's read that. These also King David dedicated to the Lord, together with the silver and gold that he dedicated from all the nations he subdued. From Edom, Moab, the Ammonites, the Philistines, Amalek, and from the spoil of Hadadezer, the son of, these names are crazy, the son of Rehob, king of Zobah. Okay, so the Hebrew word for subdue in that text there is kibosh, which simply means to subject, to subdue, to force, to keep under, to bring into bondage, to dominate, to tread down. So King David's rise was a process. Amen. King David's rise was a process. He went from a lion to a bear, then to a giant, then he conquered nations. And God is doing the same thing in your life. We're dealing with strongman devils, principalities and powers, and spiritual wickedness in high places, but we're gaining one victory after another. You're going to gain a victory tonight. You gained a victory last month, didn't you? And you're gaining a victory. You're going from victory to victory, from glory to glory. And with every victory, God increases the authority he gives you for that next mountain, for that next devil, for that next challenge, so that you can help somebody else. He's teaching and training you so you can help somebody. In Matthew chapter 10, verse 8, Jesus said, "Heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, cast out devils. Freely you have received, freely give." It's a divine process God has you on right now. You can't get to the next victory until you face and overcome that first one. You can't subdue a giant if you're running from the lion and the bear. You can't take nations for the kingdom of God if you won't face a demonic giant coming against your ministry. God has anointed your mouth. Tonight, we're going to put that into operation. Beautiful people of God, I'm here to tell you tonight that God has anointed your mouth. Amen. Your mouth. Tonight, your mouth is going to be a weapon. God has anointed your mouth and he's given you authority over your enemies for this season, for this specific season that you're in your life right now. In Mark chapter 11, verse 23, the Bible says, "Whoever says unto this mountain, be thou removed and be thou cast into the sea, and does not doubt it in his heart, but believes those things he says will come to pass, he will have whatever he says." Hallelujah. So now we're going to speak to those mountains tonight. Those demonic mountains will move. That disease will leave your body. That demonic influence will cease. In Luke 10:19, Jesus said, "Behold, I give unto you authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and on all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you." Let's get down to the Father's business. I hope that I've encouraged somebody tonight that when you follow Jesus, your life is never going to be the same. Will you follow Jesus? Will you surrender all to Jesus? Will you lay your life down on the altar of God? Will you pursue Jesus like King David did when he said, "My soul followeth hard after thee"? Let me pray for the people of God. Father, thank you tonight. Lord, thank you, Lord. Jesus, I thank you for what you're going to do right now. Thank you that you're here. Thank you for the beautiful body of Christ. Have your way tonight, Lord. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Let's go ahead and play that music. I want to lead you guys in a prayer of repentance. It all begins with repentance. Amen. Your relationship and you following Jesus all begins with repentance. Jesus said when he first came, of course, Jesus said, "Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand." And let's do that right now. We're going to just simply repent and get right with God. and God's going to have his way. Repeat this prayer with me. If you feel led to say this prayer, and if you want to get right with God and you feel you need to repent for any reason, say, Father, in Jesus' name, I repent of all sin. I believe you sent Jesus to die for my sins. I believe Jesus is the Son of God. I believe he's raised from the dead. I confess him as Lord. I want to be a genuine follower of Jesus Christ all the days of my life. Thank you, Father. Give my hand clap. Thank you, Lord. Let's pray for that perfect protection by the blood. Say this, say, by the blood of Jesus. Father, I thank you that you are protecting me. By the blood of Jesus, my life will never be the same. By the blood of Jesus, I was redeemed from the hand of the enemy. By the blood of Jesus, every generational curse breaks right now. In Jesus' name, every curse that was passed down, Father, I ask you to break it by the blood of the Lamb. In Jesus' name. Isn't Jesus wonderful tonight? Hallelujah. Let's focus on that for a few seconds. Just go ahead and just put your hand on your stomach. Let's break some curses. Break them all. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name, we break every generational curse right now. In Jesus' name, coming against the body of Christ. I break every curse of witchcraft. In Jesus' mighty name. Every curse of sickness and disease. Every curse of barrenness, rejection, fear, we break every curse now in Jesus' mighty name. Every curse of rebellion, every curse of negativity, discouragement, every evil curse coming against my life, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, Father, you are breaking it. Father, I thank you. Hallelujah. God wants to heal your body tonight. God wants to bring divine healing tonight. Amen. Does anybody have any back pain or any specific thing you need prayer for a miracle? What is it? Okay, come up here. The right ear?
Yeah.
Okay. Why don't you guys extend your hands toward him and just repeat this prayer with me. Say, in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
You deaf spirit.
You deaf spirit.
I break your power.
I break your power.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
You deaf spirit.
You deaf spirit.
Release her.
Jesus.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Devil, you have no rights.
Devil, you have no rights.
By the blood of the Lamb.
By the blood of the Lamb.
By the power of God.
By the power of God.
On the authority of God's word.
In the authority of God's word.
Deaf ear.
Deaf ear.
Unstopped and open.
Unstopped and open.
Now in Jesus' name.
Now in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. In Jesus' name,
in Jesus' name,
right ear, I command you to open,
right ear,
for the glory of Jesus Christ.
Glory of Jesus Christ.
You demonic open. Mountain of deafness, in the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to move, and open. I say, release her now,
open.
In Jesus' name.
Open. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Let's test it. Face that way. Face this way. Now, just I want you to stop. I want you to close this right ear. And just repeat after me. Out of your right ear. Say, Jesus. Jesus. Jesus loves me. Jesus, thank you. Devil, you're a liar. My ear has opened tonight. I am healed by the blood of the Lamb. Thank you, Jesus. I will follow you all the days of my life. I love Jesus. I hate the devil. Jesus, you are alive. Jesus, you are Lord. Jesus. So what's your name? Lena, tell me what's going on. Is there a difference? Is the right ear open? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's pray again. Father, I thank you in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, you deaf spirit. I charge you to release her. Release the daughter of God now for the glory of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Let's anoint you for ministry. Okay?
Yes.
Let's anoint her for ministry. She's going to lay hands on the sick and they're going to recover.
Yes.
God has called you for a supernatural holy calling. In the name of Jesus Christ, I break every spell. I break every generational curse. And I say, receive the fire of the living, resurrected Christ. Now, in Jesus' mighty name, you poor devil, you release her. In Jesus' name. Just thank him. Robobo shakalaba. Thank you, Lord. Have your way with your daughter. Have your way. Have your way. Have your way. God's going to open doors for you. You'll cast out devils and you'll heal the sick. Robobo shaka sabalaba. Train. Prepare. Are you going to follow Jesus?
Absolutely.
Is he awesome?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Does somebody have, let's pray for healing first and then we'll get into a warfare. Does somebody have, has anybody been diagnosed with diabetes in here? Okay, come up here. Because what God reveals, God heals. Hallelujah. Okay. Yeah, come up if that. Amen. You don't have to be afraid. What's your name?
Lydia.
Let's pray for Lydia. Extend your hand toward Lydia and just say, diabetes. You poor devil, you must release her right now. We are the church of the living God. You know what I know. You diabetes, come out of her right now in Jesus' mighty name. You go right now. You devil of diabetes, I say come out of her now in the mighty, holy name of Jesus Christ. Go. Go. Just receive it. Don't pray in tongues. Just receive your healing. Just thank him. Say, thank you, Lord. I am healed by the stripes and the body of the Lord Jesus Christ. I will follow Jesus all the days of my life. I am healed. Thank you, Lord. Father, you're doing it right now. Come out there, you diabetes. Go right now. On the authority of God's word, I say release her and come out of her in Jesus' name. I break that generational curse of disease. Now, go! Come out of her in Jesus' holy name. The church of the living God says, come out and release her for the glory of Jesus. Come on, give Jesus a shout. Give him a shout of praise. Will you come and give us that testimony? That disease left you. That devil left. Gone.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
You're beautiful, by the way. Hang on. I want to pray with you too, because something about you just Your life was difficult. Life was very difficult. But every mountain that you have overcome, God is gonna use that now. God is gonna unleash you. You're gonna plunder hell. You're gonna plunder hell. Drug addicts and prostitutes are going to see Jesus in you. Father, we anoint her for the ministry and the calling of God. And we say, by the divine power of the Holy Ghost, receive the fire of God. Receive the fire of God. Receive the fire of God in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Robo Shaba Klondro Robo Baronko Shaba. The Lord says He's with you, and He will be with you all the days of your life. You will never be alone. And He has given you new courage. New courage. You'll be afraid of nothing, says the Lord. Hallelujah. Rabba Bandro. Going in the name of Him who conquers all. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody else? Yes, we're going to do all that. We're going to pray for deliverance, and we're going to do everything that God wants us to do. But let's focus on anyone that needs a divine healing or a miracle. Is anybody in here blind in one eye or deaf in an ear? Anything? Nobody else? Back pain? Back pain? Okay. Okay. Okay, come here real quick. Do we have a microphone? You want to glorify Jesus, don't you?
Can you hear me?
Yes.
So last time I came and He prayed for me for diabetes. And like a week later, I went to the doctor. My A1C was at 5.0. I don't know if you all understand that. But 5.0 is not a diabetic, really. So if I go again and it's at that number, then I'll probably be taken off medication. Because
yeah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Come on, give Jesus a shout of praise. Thank you, Jesus, for healing the body of Christ. Does anybody have pain in a knee? You do? I'm sorry? Okay, we'll pray for deliverance right now, shortly. You're the one with the knee pain? Come up here. Oh, you too. Okay, come up. I'm sorry. No, both of you. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Church, will you just repeat this command and say, in Jesus' name? Pain? You demon of pain. You release the beautiful people of God. In Jesus' name, pain, come out of them now. Be healed in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Give Him glory. Thank you, Lord. It's done. Hallelujah. Move it. Do something you couldn't do before. In Jesus' name, ligaments, bones, and tendons, I command you to move and grow. Align in Jesus' name. I command his left arm to grow in the name of Jesus Christ. Move. Ligaments, bones, and tendons. Move and grow. In Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. In Jesus' mighty name. You devil causing back pain, you release her now. on the authority of God's word. According to Mark chapter 16, verse 17 and 18, they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. You shall recover. Say, I recover. Say, I'm recovered. For the glory of Jesus Christ, I'll follow Jesus all the days of my life. I'll never be the same. Thank you, Jesus. Come on, thank him. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Are you guys excited? Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Now, do something you couldn't do before. Do something you couldn't do before. Thank you, Jesus. Touchdown. What about that right knee, brother? More mobile? How does it feel? It feels different. Hallelujah. Feels different. Praise God. In the name of Jesus, be healed. Silver and gold I do not have, but what I have I give thee. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk for the glory of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. You're doing it, oh God. Be healed. In Jesus' name, receive that healing. Cast all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Go down again. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Is there a difference? Okay, well, we're going to continue to pray with you. Stay up here. All right, so you guys want to pray? Let's press in. Let's turn that music. I can't even hear that music. Can we turn that music up? Let's press in, and God's going to have his way. Amen. God is going to bless us tonight. God's going to reveal his love in a glorious way. And so if you want prayer, just come up here. I just want to lead everybody in a prayer of forgiveness. Well, we're going to forgive some people that hurt us. We're going to forgive some folks that took advantage of us. You may have been attacked. You may have been hurt. You may have been abused verbally. You may be physically abused. But we're going to obey Christ tonight and we're going to forgive. Amen. We're going to forgive. And God's gonna open, and God's gonna bless us. Jesus said, "If you forgive men their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you do not forgive men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive you." So let's do that now. Say, "In Jesus' name, I renounce unforgiveness. I forgive everybody that has ever hurt me, harmed me, attacked me, took advantage of me, abused me, in the mighty name of Jesus of Nazareth. I release all. I forgive all. I bring them to the cross. In Jesus' name, I renounce that unforgiveness and that hatred and that anger. Father, I thank you. In Jesus' name." Let's renounce that devil, every open door that we've ever given him. Let's renounce it. Say, "In Jesus' name, I renounce evil. I renounce darkness. I renounce you, Satan. I hate you, devil. You are losing authority. You are losing legal ground tonight. You will release me tonight. In Jesus' name. I renounce all witchcraft. Every open door." Now, what I want you guys to do for a few seconds is just make this personal. Right now, whatever you feel that enemy has used against you, whatever gave him a legal right, go ahead and renounce it right now. I want you to be sincere. And just say that prayer. Whatever that open door was, if you had your palm read by some psychic, if you ever had anything to do with witchcraft or the occult, simply say, "In Jesus' name, I renounce that open door to the devil." Whatever you've done, go ahead and just personalize this. Right? Close that. Let's close them doors. Whatever the open door was, in Jesus' name, I renounce the authority I gave Satan. Thank you, Lord. Now they simply have to leave. Hallelujah. By the power, on the authority that God has given you, any unclean influence or devils must release you and leave right now in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you. Let's war a good war, for like Paul said, Father, I thank you for the beautiful body of Christ. I thank you that freedom is in this place tonight. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord, for freedom and the children's bread and deliverance. I say, you rotten, defeated devil, you will release the people of God tonight. In Jesus' name, I say you must leave them right now. Every unclean devil causing sickness, every unclean devil causing fear and worry, in the name of Jesus, you come out of them right now. In Jesus' mighty name, you go right now. In the name of Jesus, you listen to me, devil. I charge you now. You release her and come out of her right now. In Jesus' name, go. Go in Jesus' name. Go in the name of Jesus. Go.
Go.
Go in Jesus' name.
Go in Jesus'
name. Come here, come here. Let them go. In Jesus' name. Lift up the holy hand. Lift up hands. In Jesus' name, you witchcraft, I command you to release her. Come out of her. In Jesus' name, you have no right. I command you, devil, go. Release her and come out now in Jesus' name. I break every yoke in Jesus' name. What's going on? What's
anxiety?
Before
I'm baptized,
one of the
psychic reading.
Okay. Now let me ask you this. Who hurt you, though? What started everything?
I don't know. Since I was going to be baptized, which just came on.
There's a soul wound where you've been hurt. Someone took advantage of you.
Yes, Pastor. I've been getting abused from when I was little.
Okay.
And I also used to be into an abusive relationship.
Okay. Say in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
I release that person. What's their name?
His name is Gregory White.
Say Gregory White.
Gregory White.
I release you.
I release you.
I forgive you.
I forgive you.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
By the blood of Jesus.
By the blood of Jesus.
I renounce.
I renounce
every open door.
Every open door
to Satan.
To Satan.
I renounce the authority I gave Satan.
I renounce the authority I gave Satan.
Through the palm reading.
And the voodoo and the psychics.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Let me pray for you now, okay?
Yes, sir,
Father,
you.
I thank you for your daughter. I break that yoke in Jesus' name on the authority of God's word. I break every curse now. In Jesus' name. I break the band over her mind. I break every demon spell. In Jesus' name. I break every demon yoke now. In Jesus' name, listen to me, Satan. I break your power. You heard her, devil. You must release her. You will release her. You will release her in Jesus' name. Say this, devil, I hate you.
Devil, I hate you.
You cannot stay.
You cannot stay.
You leave my life.
You leave my life.
Tonight.
Tonight.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
You come out of me right now.
You come out of me right now.
You witchcraft, come out of her in Jesus' name.
You witchcraft,
come out of her in Jesus' name. You unclean spirits causing anxiety, worry, demonic influence, bondage, fear, shame, sexual sin. Come out of her. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' mighty name. Come out. You release her. You release the daughter of God in Jesus' mighty name. Take a deep breath or get a good dislodge. Go now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hang on. I don't want you to go anywhere, okay? And you can have your son sit down. You can have your kid sit down for a second.
He has ADHD.
Okay. We'll pray for him right now, but I want someone else to pray with you right now. Where's Kelly? I need some of the ministry team up here. Okay, stay right here.
I still have the ringing in my ear.
Okay. In the name of Jesus Christ, open. Open. Thank you, Lord. 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 In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, what's going on?
Nerve.
Okay. What happened when you were young? Someone hurt you?
No, I went to the hospital. You were shot. Blood pressure cuff was put on me correctly. I'm in my 8 month like this.
Okay. Did your family, were you raised on the when you were growing up, was there any kind of involvement with the occult? Like any kind of I'm sorry? Medicine man. Okay. So let's come against that. What was his name?
My dad's name was Joe.
Say in Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
I release my dad.
I release
Joe. I forgive him. In Jesus' name. I renounce the authority that was given to Satan through my dad. You heard that, devil. In Jesus' name, I break the spell. I break every demon yoke now. In Jesus' mighty name. I break that yoke. I break that curse right now in Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' holy name, I break that yoke. You medicine man devil, you are exposed tonight. In Jesus' name, you release her. Now, come out of her. Come out. Go ahead, let it out. Just give a cough or a burp or a yawn. And I want you to fight, okay? They're coming out. Say, devil, I hate you. Holy anger. That you release me now. I follow Jesus. Come out of her right now. You unclean spirits. Come out of her in Jesus' name. I break that chain. I break that yoke right now. You medicine man. You unclean spirits from the medicine man. Indian inheritance. Peyote. Unclean devils. Come out of her. Come out of her in Jesus' mighty name. By the love of Jesus Christ, release her now. Come out of her in Jesus' name. I want you to fight. I want you to say, devil, come out of me now in Jesus' mighty name. Come out of me now. Go in Jesus' name. I break that disease. I break off that sickness right now. Devil, you know what I know. In Jesus' name. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out of her. Come out of her now in Jesus' mighty name. Go. Go. Go right now. Go. Sickness, go. You unclean devil, come out. Go right now in Jesus' name. Now. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I want you to dislodge them. Say, devil, come out of me now. Then I want you to get a good cough or a burp or a yawn. They come out with a breath. You Indian inheritance medicine man, unclean devil, you have lost your power. This is holy ground. Release her. Now, come out of her. Come out of her in Jesus' mighty name. Go in Jesus' mighty name. Come out of her. There's you have the anointing. Quickly, act now and get them out now. Ah, there you go. Come out of her in Jesus' name. Come out of her, you unclean devil. You unclean devil. Generational devil, come out of her. Generational devil, come out. Now, in the mighty name of Jesus, generational curses from the family tree. Generational hexes and spells. Witchcraft. You strong man of a medicine man. Out now. Out now. Release her. Release her now. Release her now in Jesus' name. Now, come out of her. Come out of her in Jesus' name. Thank you, Lord. 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 Come out of her now in Jesus' name. Come out of her in Jesus' holy, mighty name. Go in Jesus' name. Go in Jesus' name. Come out.
Got it.
This family right here. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, by the anointing and the love of God, you devil, you're exposed. You must leave the daughter of God tonight. Now, you will release her. You will come out of her now. You will come out of her now. In Jesus' name, release her neck. Release her body. In Jesus' mighty name, I break that witchcraft of disease now. In Jesus' mighty name, you release her now. Go in Jesus' name. Go now. Come out of her. Come out of her in Jesus' name. Fight, fight, fight. Say, I release my dad. I release my dad to the cross. I renounce the medicine man. I renounce.
Stood before creation, eternity in your hand, and you spoke the earth into motion, my soul now is dead. You stood before. Carry the cross for my shame. My sin weighed upon your shoulders. My soul now is dead. So what could I say? What could I do? I believe.
Hey, if anybody wants to pray for the baptism of the Holy Ghost, come up here right now. We're going to pray for the baptism of the Holy Spirit right now. So if you don't pray in tongues, or if you do pray in tongues and you just want to receive more of the fire of God, just line up. Let's act on that now. Do that now. Come on. Come up here. Let's pray for the fire of God.
Yeah. Just like
If you need the baptism of fire, the baptism of the Spirit and fire, come up here right now. In Jesus' name, how are you? Okay. Say, just repeat this prayer after me. Say, Father, in Jesus' name, I ask for the baptism of the Holy Ghost and fire. In Jesus' mighty name, by faith, I receive it now. I believe it is your will. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father. You're doing it, oh God. I receive tongues of fire from heaven now by faith in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Just thank him for it now. Say thank you, Lord, for this baptism of fire. Say thank you, Lord, for your power. Say thank you, Lord. I thank you that you've done it, oh God. And now we need to put our faith into action, okay? Because the Bible says that they began to speak with new tongues as the Spirit gives them utterance. That means you got to do the speaking, okay? God's not going to force, he's not going to move your mouth for you. So you'll be speaking in a new heavenly language. It may sound like a bunch of syllables, okay? But it sounds a little something like this. Robobo, shibo, ba ba ba, bondro, robobo. Just magnify God with tongues as a fire. Robo, shakarabaraba. Receive the fire in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus Christ, receive the fire of God. Now you already have it. Now just put your faith into action. There it is. Go ahead, receive that fire. Receive that fire. Go ahead, now go ahead, start speaking in tongues. Go ahead.
Joy, the reason I come alive, God, the reason I
There must be more than this. Oh, breath of God, come breathe within. There must be more than this. Spirit of God, we wait for you. Sing that again. There must be more than this. Oh, breath of God, come breathe with me. There must be more than this. Spirit of God, we wait for you. Fill us anew, we pray. Fill us anew, we pray. Consuming fire, fan into flame. A passion for like a rushing wind, fill us with power from on high. Now set the captives free. We must abandon to your grace. Lord, let your glory fall. Yeah.